Hi students, let me explain you the concept of class and objects by taking a Java program example. So I am opening a notepad here. So I am writing a class with the name, shape, and I am declaring two variables double of type double. So length and breadth I have taken here. Class, let me name the class as shape demo. In this class, we are writing main method, public static void main string args. So, see, look here, this is the name of the class. One object you have declared here. This is called the declaration of an object of class shape. Okay. Now, in order to allocate memory to that, you need to use new keyword of type shape. Here what happens is memory for double L and B will be allocated to object 1. Object 1. Memory to L and B. Okay. Are allocated to object 1. So, this is one way of creation of object. Let me create one more object of class shape. So, shape. I can create in a single line. Instead of using two lines, here itself you can create. New. Also a valid statement. During declaration itself, you have allocated the memory also. So, for object 2 also, L and B, the two double memory is allocated to that. Now, look here. We have to assign values to that by using how to access variables of class declared. By using object, object 1 dot L is equal to 10, I have given, and object 1 dot B is equal to 20. This is assigning values to, here I am assigning values to variables of first object, object 1. Next, what am I doing? We will assign values to variables of object 2. So, here for object 2, I will assign 30 and 40. Okay. So, now let me declare a variable int area, or both, as both are of type double, let me declare of type double area. Okay, is equal to 0 simply I have initialized it. Now you see, I am calculating area is equal to object 1 dot L into object 1 dot B. Now system dot out dot println area of object 1 is what area. In the above line we have calculated, or here itself you can use that statement also. Next, what I do is I will calculate area for the second object. Here is the second object. Here I used semicolon. Here also semicolon. Okay. So let me print the area of second object here, and we'll see what the result is. So, for public static main, I am closing the program here, and next for class. class I have closed. Now, remember, we have to give the name of the class in which public static void is existing. So, shape demo should be the name of the Java file, but not shape here. Remember, there can be any number of classes, but the class name which contains public static void name, void main, should be used as the file name. So, file, save. So, let me save it with the name shape-demo.java. Go to command prompt. So, our program I saved in the folder java2.csc, which is in desktop. Now, I am compiling the program with the name shape-demo.java. We'll see if any errors are there. So, no errors. Now, let me run the program. So, for first object, do you remember 10 and 20 we have given? So, L into B, 10 into 20 is 200. For the second object, 30, 40 we have given. 30 into 40, 1200 we got the answer. So, the point you have to understand here is, though for this class shape, we are able to create two objects. And for two objects, memory allocation is different. So, for the same class, you can have any number of objects and they have their own memory for the contents which in within the class. So, L and B values for object 1 is different and for object 2 is different. And by using dot operator, object dot, and then using this variable names, you have to access the variables of class. Object dot variable name is the syntax how we have to access the class variables. Okay, so you try for to find length into breadth into height. Take that as homework, calculate and then send me the answer.